Hello guys, today I would like to show you this Wi-Fi smart switch. I'm going to show you how to pair it with the mobile app to see how easy it is to do that, how quickly you can switch it on and off from the mobile app, and I'm going to use the multimeter to show you something that I'm not sure if it's a problem or not, but I don't know. I'm not that good at electrical stuff. You will see what I'm talking about. So, what I did, I already connected some wires to the device, and I'm going to power it up. So now it's powered up. A solid green light means that the device is connected to the Wi-Fi network. In this case, it isn't. And this is the mobile app. It's called EWE Link. I'm not sure if you can see it. This is the name of the app. It's available for Apple devices and for Android devices. So I already have it installed here. Let me show you how it looks. So you first have to register. I already did that. I'm going to select my country. I will type my email address and password. And I'm just going to press on login. So now it's logging in. And let's see how easy it is to pair the device. So I have to keep this button pressed for 7 seconds until the green light will switch on and off quickly, like that. Click on the plus sign in the app, click on next. I'll have to type the password for my Wi-Fi network. And click next. Found first generation device. That's what it says. So it found the device. It's asking for permission to turn Wi-Fi on and off. That's for when you have the Wi-Fi turned off. So the device was added and now it's active. Let's use the multimeter to check the voltage, and this is one of the problems. So you are not seeing this. So I have 21 volts, even though the device is not turned on, the switch is not turned on. Now it's switched on and I have 230 volts. I switch it off 18-19 volts. I'm not sure if this is a problem or not, but it's strange. I would expect it 0 volts. One more time. I think you can even hear on the recording the moment when the switch turns on and off. You can turn this device, the switch actually, on and off, not only with the mobile app, but also by holding the this button here for a few seconds. Now it's on, off. So that's all that I wanted to show you. That's the pairing process, and this little anomaly, I would say. I'm not sure if it's a problem or not, but it's something that I didn't expect. So that's all. Thank you for watching. Bye.